Spaying a cat means removing her ovaries and uterus. Surgery begins once the patient has been prepared by veterinary support staff, been given pain medication, and is at an appropriate plane of anesthesia. First, an incision is made through the skin layer of the ventral abdomen. A hemostat, or scissors, are then used to clear fat and tissue from this area, so the surgeon has an unobstructed view of the next layer. They then cut through a central band of fibrous tissue and into the abdomen, creating an opening that allows them access to the abdominal organs. A spay hook is now used to carefully sweep across the inside of the abdomen. It is used to pick up either the uterine horn or the broad ligament, which is attached to the uterine horn. The ovary can now be pulled through the incision opening. Any extra tissue is placed back in the abdomen. Next, to gain better access to the ovary, the suspensory ligament is severed and a window is made in the broad ligament. The pedicle is now autoligated, meaning tied on itself in a knot. There may be an increased heart rate at this time due to surgical stimulation. The ovary is now cut away. The knot is tightened, and once the surgeon confirms that there is no bleeding, known as hemostasis, or remaining ovarian tissue, the pedicle is returned into the cat's body. Next, the broad ligament is cleared away from the uterine horn. Tracing the track to the second ovary, the process is repeated. The suspensory ligament is severed. A window is made. The pedicle is autoligated. The ovary is cut away. The knot is secured, and the surgeon confirms hemostasis. Once the surgeon has completed the second side and cleared any tissue from the uterus, a strangle knot is used to tie off the uterine body. Additional knots may be placed in more complicated surgeries, such as pyometras or pregnant spays. The knot is tightened and additional throws are used to secure it. The uterine body is now cut away. A small tissue tag is left behind and is put back inside the cat's body once the surgeon confirms hemostasis. Next, the muscle layer of the abdomen is closed with a special type of crisscrossing pattern called a cruciate pattern. Incisions less than 2 centimeters will typically need only one of these sutures, but a larger incision will require more. It is secured using square knots. A veterinary assistant then splashes a small amount of topical anesthetic into the incision site for additional pain control. With a first layer of closure complete, the skin is now closed with a purse string closure. This suture pattern is again secured with square knots. Tissue glue is applied to the top of the skin over the incision, which acts as a barrier to dirt and debris. Finally, as with all of our surgeries, we place a small green tattoo to indicate that the cat has been sterilized. Here, we place it next to the incision. We then seal the tattoo with surgical glue. Community cats also receive an ear tip in order to identify them from a distance as being sterilized.